Today we're in Duggan to watch the beautiful game and meet the community leaders who make it happen.
Concession needs 7 packages of hot dogs. We will let the kitchen know here. Is anybody in the kitchen on the radio right now?
Well, I guess I have to give the blame or the credit to my husband because he's been a soccer aficionado since he was a child. And we had tournaments in and around the city, but about 9 or 10 years ago, he noticed we didn't have one in our area. And then a gentleman by the name of Mr. Ann Nguyen from Empire Parks had a little tournament going, and he was doing a great job, but he just didn't have enough volunteers to keep it going or to make it grow. So what Duggan did is they approached Empire Park and they said, why don't we put our heads together and we'll call it the Duggan Empire Park Tournament. So 9 years ago, we started out with 51 teams, and it grew like topsy, and at one point we had 191 teams, and we said we've got to cut this back a bit. So now we run with between 170 and 180 teams per year. I mix my tournament stuff in with everything else, as my friends and family will tell you. So if they walk in the room, they can get delegated a job. Myself, usually the last 2 weeks before are pretty well tournament occupied.
I want to confirm whether it's fun or...
Oh, that is a good question. It's just kind of a way of life we have as a family, as many families here in Duggan are. They pitch in, whether it's, you know, helping a friend who's sick. In fact, one of our greatest volunteers passed away a few weeks ago. So we're all mourning her loss and thinking about her, you know, all the time at the tournament and trying to rally around her family. And when we have others that come in new to the community and we make friends with them. And so it becomes more than a soccer tournament. It just becomes a way of getting along with people.
Guys, don't play before!
Soccer is my passion as well. I grew up playing soccer. I was born and raised in Ethiopia. And I think I started playing soccer, you know, since I started walking probably. So this is my passion, and it's a very good sport, very, very good sport. It's economically one of probably the cheapest sports that you can go to. So I was active as a coach, and I'm still coaching now in my community, and I say, you know what? We can do something more in this community. What can I give? What can we as a community give to the soccer development of Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, and hopefully the world? So that drive, that passion to see the development of soccer, to see more and more Canadian kids play soccer, is the main intent, the main purpose of why I joined this, or we start working on this tournament. It really brings joy to, it makes me extremely happy to see, for me to see this many kids play soccer, and parents, grandparents, relatives, friends coming and watching them in this beautiful Saturday afternoon in Edmonton. To me, this is an amazing thing. It's just a huge pleasure. It's awesome.
This tournament means a lot for our community. As the soccer director, we noticed it a lot this year is, being in my first year, is with this tournament, we are the only community tournament in Alberta as far as I know. And with that, we try to get as many community teams in, and with that, we keep the rates down because we're not really looking at just making money. We're letting people do that. But any money that comes does go to the soccer committee in Duggan, and that really helps keep our fees down. And that means a lot of kids, more kids can play because it makes it a lot more reasonable for them to play. And we have one of the lowest fees in Edmonton right now in Duggan.
From the Duggan Empire Park Soccer Tournament, I'm Nancy Rempel. Join me next time for another great Community League story.